Hello students, welcome to my guest classes. In this presentation we are going to discuss about NEET 2020 phase 2 question number from 16 to 20. The previous questions have been discussed in the videos and links are given in the description box. Let us move into the question. The question number 16, identify the wrongly matched pair. The left hand side of the molecules are given. The right hand sides, the geometries are given, which one is wrong? So it is discussed on the basis of valence shell electron pair repulsion theory, that is valence VSC pair theory. In the VSC pair theory, it explains the geometry of the simple molecules like ammonia, PCl5, etc. Now the structure of the shape or geometry of the molecule. In ammonia, how the molecule is predicted? See NH3. The total valence electrons in ammonia is 5 from nitrogen and 3 electrons from 3 hydrogen, and totally it is 8. This total valence electron is divided by 2 in the next step. So first step, we have to calculate the number of total valence electron. In the second step, the total electrons are divided by the number 2. If the total valence electron exceeds more than 8, you have to divide the value by 8. Here it is 8 and so it is divided by 2. This is equal to 4. This 4 indicates the molecule is sp3 hybridized. If the quotient is 2, then it is sp, and 3 it is sp2, 4 it is sp3, 5 it is sp3d, and 6 it is sp3d2, and so on. Here the ammonia involves sp3 hybridization. In the first step, the number of bond pairs and lone pairs are identified. So here 3 hydrogen atoms. So it is 3 bond pair and 1 lone pair. Here there are 4 pairs of electrons. So because of this lone pair electrons, the geometry is not a regular tetrahedral. It is trigonal pyramidal in shape. Okay. So the ammonia is correctly matched. The next one, PCl5. So total valence electron is equal to 5 from phosphorus and 35 from 5 chlorine atoms. Each chlorine has 7 electrons in the outer shell. Say halogen atom, all the halogen atom having 7 electrons in the outer cells. So total 40. Okay. In the second step, this 40 is divided by 8. So the quotient is 5. If the quotient is 5, what is hybridization? It is sp3d. In the first step, all the five orbitals are bond pair. There is no lone pair. So it is a regular geometry, that is trigonal pi pyramidal in shape. So PCl5 has this shape. Trigonal pi pyramidal. But is it given trigonal planar? It is wrongly matched. Okay. Similarly, the SF6. SF6, total number of valence electrons. TV is equal to 6 from sulfur. So 6 and chlorine. Fluorine. Each fluorine has 7 electrons. So totally it is 42. So total it is 48. The second step, the 48 is divided by 8. The quotient is 6. If the quotient is 6, the hybridization is sp3d2. And also all 6 bonds are bond pair. And so it is regular octahedral in shape. So it is correctly matched. The last one, beryllium chloride. Beryllium, the total valence electron is equal to 2 plus 14. Is equal to 16. 2 from the beryllium and 14 from chlorine atom 16. Then the second step, 16 is divided by 8, you get 2, the quotient is 2. If the quotient 2, it is sp hybridization, and the 2 pair of electrons are, the quotient is equal to the pair of electrons, and so you have 2 pair of electrons, so it is 2 bond pair, there is no lone pair, it is a regular shape, it is linear, it is correctly matched. The identified wrongly matched pair is PCl5. PCl5 is wrongly matched. It is trigonal pyramidal in shape. Next question, question number 17. Which of the following statement is not true about acid rain? Its pH is less than 5.6. It is the data. And it is due to the reaction of sulfur dioxide, NO2 and CO2 with rainwater. So this statement is correct. So the acid rain is formed due to the formation of the pollutants SO2, NO2, carbon dioxides dissolves in rainwater to give sulfuric acid, nitric acid, carbonic acid respectively. So this statement is correct. It causes no damage to monuments like Taj Mahal. It causes damage to the monuments like Taj Mahal. So this statement is, it is given no damage to monuments. So it is a wrong statement. So it is not true. It is harmful for plants. We know that, and its pH is less than 5.6. And acid rain causes damage to the buildings, which is made up of marbles or limestone. So Taj Mahal is made up of a marble. So it is calcium carbonate. With the calcium carbonate, the acids like sulfuric acid or the carbonic acid reacts to give the calcium sulfate, and so it is corroded by the acid rain. Your answer is C. Question number 18. Which of the following is a free radical substitution reaction? Which of the following is a free radical substitution reactions? So the first one, A, propene. Propene, the reaction is CH3CH double bond CH2 propene with the HBr. So this reaction, in the presence of benzoate radical, due to the presence of double bond, it undergoes addition reaction. So the propene with HBr is this reaction. And benzene with the bromine and AlCl3. Benzene. Benzene reacts with the bromine. In the presence of aluminium chloride, it is a substitution reaction. And the benzenic is present, and so it is electrophilic substitution reaction. It is electrophilic. Then acetylene with the HBr. Acetylene, that is CH triple bond CH plus HBr. The Br is added here and the hydrogen is added here. The product is CH2 double bond CH Br. Here this reaction is addition reaction. So the answer A and C may not be the answer. The D, methane reacts with the bromine in the presence of light to give methyl bromide. It is a substitution reaction. It follows the free radical. In the first of Br2 dissociate to give 2 Br radical. So it is initiated with the Br radical, and so it is free radical substitution reaction. Your answer is D. So your answer is methane with the BrH2. Okay. Question number 19. If for a certain reaction del H is 30 kJ mole inverse, at 450 Kelvin, the value of del S in joule Kelvin inverse mole inverse for which of the same reaction will be spontaneous at the same temperature? The question is, what is the del S value? Del H is given. The del G and the del H is related as del G is equal to del H minus T del S. For a spontaneous reaction, del G is negative or it is less than 0. By substituting this equation, you can get del H minus T delta S is less than 0. Or you can write that del H is less than T delta S. So delta S is, so you can write that T delta S is greater than del H. Clear? So delta S is greater than del H phi. So it is positive quantity. So the del S is the positive quantity. So your answer A and C is may not be the answer. Okay. Here you get a value delta H is equal to 30 kilojoule. So it is 30,000 joule and divided by 450 Kelvin. So it is approximately 67.7. So the answer is B. Alternatively, we have do this problem. That is, del G is negative for the spontaneous reaction. And so this quantity is greater than that of the del H value. Okay. So del H, you know that del G is equal to, it is 30,000 minus D delta. So D delta S quantity should be greater than this 30,000. Correct. So here it is given to 450 Kelvin and del S value. Suppose you substitute this 330, it is around 14,000. So the del G will be positive. Suppose in case it is substituted, it is multiplied by 70, it will be 33 joules. So the 70 may be the answer. By guessing, you can write the answer also, and by substituting, you get answer. So theoretically, del G is equal to del H minus T delta S. T delta is greater than del H. It is clear. Okay, then only DG will be negative. So delta S is positive. So A and C may not be the answer. And the T delta S quantity should be greater than that of the 30,000. So we are substituting 70 in case of del S value. Only this quantity will be negative. Otherwise, you substitute the 33, it will be positive again. Okay. Next one. This is question number 20. Match the compound X in column 1 with the molecular structure in column 2. So again, it is based on the VSEPR theory. We can find out the structure. In case of XCF2, the total valence electron 8 plus 14, it is 22. The 22 is divided by 8, you get the quotient 2, and the remainder is 6. Okay, again the remainder is divided by 2, it is less than 8, and so it is divided by 2, you get 3 quotient in the second case. So total quotient is 5. So if the quotient is 5, it is sp3 dehybridization. Okay, sp3 dehybridization, the structure is trigonal by pyramidal. XCF2, there is a 2 bond pairs and 3 lone pairs. Totally 5 pairs are present, so it is 2 bond pair and lone pair. So the trigonal bipyramidal shape will be like that. This anion and the 3 equatorial position, there is a 3 lone pair electrons are occupied. So the geometry or shape is not trigonal bipyramidal, it is a linear in structure. Okay, so A is linear in shape, it is even in the all the A option. So the next we have to go in case of B, that is xenon tetrafluoride. B, xenon tetrafluoride, the total valence electron is equal to 8 plus 28, it is equal to 36. The 36 is divided by 8, so you get 4 quotient, 4 8s are 32, and the remaining 4 is the remainder 1. And this remainder again divided by 2 is equal to 2, the next quotient is 2, so total 6. If it is quotient is 6, it is 6 pair of electron, the hybridization is sp3d2. Here the xenon has 4 bond pair and 2 lone pair. For sp3d2 hybridization, the safe is the octahedral. Due to the presence of 2 lone pair electron, it is not a regular octahedral. So the safe of the molecule is, so octahedral having the safe XF fluoride, and the 2 fluorines are occupied in the direction. So it is a square planar in safe. And so the XCF4 is a square planar in safe. So B is 1. So C and D may not be the answer. Okay. Next is XCO3. See, is XCO3, the total valence electron the same, it is 8 plus 3, 6 or 18, it is totally 26. If it is 26, you have to divide by 8, you get the 3 quotient and 2 is the remainder. This remainder again divided by 2, you get 1 quotient. So totally 4 pair of electrons are present. The hybridization is sp3. Here the 3 bond pair and 1 lone pair is present. Okay, so the regular tetrahedral shape is not present. Due to the presence of lone paired electrons, it is pyramidal in shape. So the regular tetrahedron, the xenon, is in the form of the pyramidal in the shape. And your option is fourth one. The fourth one is given in the C option. And see the D, xenon oxyfluoride. The case of xenon oxyfluoride, the total valence electron is equal to 8 plus 6 plus 28. So it is 42. So 42 is divided by 8, you get quotient 5, it's a 40, and 2 is the remainder. Then the remainder is divided by 2, you get 1. So total quotient is 6. It is sp3d2 hybridization, regular surface octahedral. Here 5 bond pairs and 1 lone pair is present. And so the shape is square pyramidal. Okay. So the option is A. So XCF2 is the linear, XCF4 square planar, XCO3 pyramidal, and XCO4 square pyramidal. Okay. In this way, you can easily find out the geometry of the simple molecules using this technique. Okay, students, up to this we have stopped this presentation. We will meet in the next video. I hope that it is useful to you. Thank you for watching.